Hi and welcome back to The Shtick. Keeping in line with cinema talk, we've got with us in her home, Lindy Tamir. Hi, Lindy.
Hi, nice to be here.
Nice to see you. I used to see you all the time at the Classic. What happened?
who's seeing anybody?
No, I know. So you're involved with...
Actually, it's true. The community doesn't have a community centre at the moment. I mean, one thing, the synagogues are closed, but the Classic cinemas...
I know. Now we've got one place where the community can come, and that's to The Shtick. We're still doing a show every week. And we're showing the best of our people, and you're one of the best people I know.
So we were open for 2 weeks. It was wonderful. We were only allowed 20 in each cinema, but we were so happy. And actually with JobKeeper, somehow we managed to make it work and like not slightly profitable, you know, and then we had to close. And it's so much work to close and then to open and then to close
and then
to open again.
Tragic. And the same is in Hawthorn with the LIDO and in Belgrave with the Cameo. Same thing.
But we have in Sydney.
Yes.
For about a year now, the RITZ Cinemas, and that's open. And it's got a different rule there. Like we can a quarter fill the cinemas.
Uh-huh.
So like there's at the RITZ, there's a beautiful grand 800 seater and we're allowed 200 in there. And so people at this stage coming to the movies in Sydney, and that's a big saviour for us. So we're working at a level.
And you've got an umbrella now over all the cinemas called Moving Story Entertainment. I like that.
Yeah, it was a way to umbrella that our cinemas aren't a chain name. So we needed just a business umbrella name, and also we've got film festivals. So. Everything's a moving story enterprise.
Yeah, you've still got JIFF and you've got CHIFF and now you've got FFFA.
Oh, you got it. Fantastic film festival, a genre film festival.
Yes.
Yeah, we do three festivals spread over the year.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we've got a small team with Erin that runs that.
Yeah, I mentioned Erin when I spoke to Danny. She's running all the festivals. And you've also got something called Female Gaze.
So we've got our at-home service. So actually when we were closed down the first time, everybody said pivot, you know, and we thought, well, cinemas, how do cinemas pivot? So we thought up about doing an isolation short film festival.
Yes.
And that was amazing, not for making money, just a beautiful thing to do. And then suddenly we thought about, everybody was saying, oh, just put your films online.
But
you can't just stream the new James Bond film. You know, people just think, just put it all up, you know. But we did actually start a streaming service. We're the first cinemas in Australia to do it.
Wonderful.
So it's under each cinema's name. So you go onto the Classic website. It's Classic at Home or RITZ, RITZ at Home, Cameo, Cameo at Home, and LIDO, LIDO at Home. And we've got hundreds of films on that we've created. Eddie does the programming. That is recent films, current films because of the situation at the moment, and beautiful retro films. But it's like coming to our cinema because everything's been selected. It's not, you won't find rubbish on it. You'll come on and, it's a, you pay per viewing a few dollars and it's hundreds of amazing films. Yeah.
Right, and it's either rent or buy. You've got the option to buy as well?
Yeah, buy so you can watch it anytime, or rent from when you watch it, you've got 48 hours.
That's pretty cool. And how has the COVID-19 lockdown affected you more or less? I mean, the whole cinema industry is the same.
Yeah, it's really sad for us. Probably the toughest thing is that magnificent films that would have been up at cinemas went to streaming. And that's tough for us because they're films that are meant to come to the big screen.
Yes.
And it's just with this lockdown again and with America in such a bad situation, it's just film after film keeps happening. Yeah, so that's the biggest damage. That yes, the business and the money and everything, that we'd have to be strong to grow again, but we need the product. So, you know, perhaps, yeah, it depends when the world gets healthy, but if Australia can hurry up and be a healthy island, we can find beautiful art films, and we're playing a lot of retro films, and we can make a business. And then in the future, the big films, the blockbusters, they want the cinema. They're holding out, the real, you know, mostly, you know. But sometimes there's no choice at the moment, and they go straight.
Well, the good news is that you've got a Hungarian cake shop opening up next door.
Well, we're so lucky. There is a Sydney company called Kurtosh. Mm. Few places in Sydney, and in Melbourne they have opened in downstairs in the LIDO cinemas in the LIDO Arcade.
Oh, right, in the arcade.
Yeah,
and now they're opening in Elsternwick.
Also next to the Classic, they're renovating now.
Yes,
and they'll be open in a couple of months' time. And so, what more? That's just what you want. Late night, they're open after the movies, and you go in there. You choose your poppy seed cake, and they weigh it and just 50 different exciting cakes, like in the old-fashioned style, and it's run by a Hungarian, Israeli family doing their old Hungarian recipes from the family.
Wonderful. Anyway, it's been really great to have you on the Shtick again. We've had you and Eddie alternating as a relay team every year, and I really hope that the cinema industry can get back on its feet again, because you are so vital in our cultural, especially with JIFF, in our cultural genre, and the whole underlying thing that we love is going to the Classic. I'm just, you know, like, it's such a great meeting place.
Well, JIFF will be, if we need to, we'll move it. It'll be in the cinema at the Classic. That's the only, and the other cinemas, but at the Ritz, it's the only way we'll do it. We'll wait for the world, but we'll be playing JIFF in the cinemas.
By November, we'll be up and running.
Maybe a little bit later, but we'll stay tuned.
Famous last words. Shalom, say goodbye.
See you. I go back to Leo, my grandson.
Yeah, mazel tov. Send my regards to all the family.
Thanks. Take
Bye.
Care. Bye.
And we'll be back next week with more Shtick, like we do every week.
Bollywood, renowned for its singing, dancing, and melodrama. But it's Jews? Who would have thought it? Jewish superstars of India's silver screen. This is their story. When Indian cinema began over 100 years ago, it was taboo for Hindu and Islamic women to perform in public. But in a nation of over a billion Hindus, almost 300 million Muslims, and millions of Christians, were a few thousand Jews. It was a nice Jewish girl called Ruby Myers who shattered the taboo on female acting. From the early 1920s, she was the silent era queen of the silver screen, who went by the stage name of Sulochana, which means the one with the beautiful eyes. Sulochana blazed a trail other Jewish women soon followed. Welcome to Bollywood, Pramila. This is Bollywood's unknown story. The Jewish superstars who put the shalom into Bollywood.